Government Medical Officers Association has a history of over 90 years, and during these 90 years we have always behaved in a highly professional, highly ethical manner, ensuring the rights of our members as well as developing our profession to benefit the people of this country. At a time there is a issue regarding the Mara Bay Sidearm Institute, and at the moment we are having discussions with the Honorable Prime Minister. We feel that they are very productive discussions, and we feel that the Honorable Prime Minister is having a proper and an informed stand on this issue, and he wants to resolve this issue for the benefit of the people of his country. And we saw the President, His Excellency the President, making the same attempt few weeks ago, trying to solve this issue and give it a permanent and acceptable solution, which ultimately ended up in heartbreak for all those who are involved with us. And because of a letter issued from the Secretary of the President, and we all know how this happened and who was behind sabotaging the President's initiative of bringing about a peaceful resolution to this issue. And now the latest development in this whole saga, we saw yesterday that a parallel union, a separate union, was formed at the Foundation Institute yesterday afternoon. And this was under the patronage, sad to say, of the present Health Minister. Instead of helping the negotiations, making a positive contribution to the negotiations to end this Sidearm conflict for the benefit of the country, it is being dragged into more and more confusion and complications by trying to wean off members from the Government Medical Officers Association, and thereby trying to sabotage this whole process. And we categorically say that the Government Medical Officers Association cannot be destroyed or weakened by any politician or any other organization with vested interest. During the 90-year-old history of the Government Medical Officers Association, we have taken principal stand on many issues, and we have done trade union actions on many issues and done many campaigns. And during all these issues, some politicians have attempted to destroy the GMOA by dividing it, but they have failed to do so in a miserable manner. The same attempt which was done yesterday would also suffer the same fate. And we must say that under the Health Minister's patronage, they would only muster less than 50 doctors for this so-called trade union. And we believe that these medical officers who have been involved in this were already suspended from Government Medical Officers Association on disciplinary grounds. So our message is, do not try to complicate this issue, do not make people of this country suffer, and do not try to divide the Government Medical Officers Association, because that is something that cannot be achieved. That is something which has not been achieved in 90-year-old history of our union, and we don't see that efforts like this will result in achieving destruction of our union happening in the near future or in the distant future. And we urge all those who want to destroy our union, we are strong because we take principled stand. We are strong because we base all our proposals on study aspect. We study facts and then come to conclusions and then come to our proposals or our opinions on issues. That is our strength. And the membership, or more than 80% of the doctors, government doctors, are with the union, and those doctors will never betray the union. There may be a disgruntled few, but those few are not enough to make any impact on any issue related to our union. And therefore, we ask the health minister to contribute positively to this negotiating process for the sake of the people of the country and the sake of the government he is a part of.